What is up, guys? RamHanawan here, and welcome to today's video. Now, today, I am covering a deck profile for a deck that I made myself. Didn't that deck, didn't actually have any inspiration for this deck from any other decks I saw. This was, like, all off the top of my head. And I basically started building this deck around Machi Machi Magician Girl and Naruto the Moral Leader, because those are two pretty powerful rank 6 XYZ monsters. But their only downside is that you need two level 6 spellcaster monsters to summon them. So, like I said, the inspiration behind this deck was to build something that could summon these cards fairly consistently. And then it just evolved into a rank 6 XYZ deck. And it's actually a pretty good one at that. So anyway, just going to go over the cards here. We got 3 Battle Faders, 2 Gaius the Shadow Monarch, 3 Cyber Valley, 2 Delg the Dark Monarch, 2 Eren Lightsworn Monk, 3 Light Ray Mador, 3 Light Ray Sorcerer, 2 Reza the Storm Monarch, 3 Soul of Purity and Light, 3 Treebon Frog, 1 Dark Hole, 3 Enemy Controller, 1 Foolish Burial, 1 Heavy Storm, 1 Hell's Gate, 1 Monster Reborn, 1 1 for 1, 2 Reasoning, and 3 Soul Release. And then in my side deck I have 3 XYZ Encore. I'm just really testing that card out right now, so it's not really part of this deck, so if you just want to ignore that for now. As far as the extra deck, I just got some pretty powerful rank 6 XYZ monsters. Rank 6 XYZ monsters are pretty powerful in general, so I got 2 Concealer, 2 Gauntlet Launcher, 2 Insector Exa Beetle, 2 Machi Machi, 2 Naruto, 2 Number 72, 2 Photon Strike Bouncer, and then 1 Swordbreaker. The reason I've got that 1 Swordbreaker in at the end is because in some situations it can be useful, so I've got it there anyway. So like I said, yeah, this is basically used to XYZ summon rank 6, and there's lots of different ways you can do that. So first off, I've got the Treeborn slash Monarch build thrown into this thing. And the reason that's thrown into this thing is because those are great ways to summon rank 6 monsters. And just Monarchs on its own would probably be a good way to summon rank 6, although not as consistently as I have made with this deck. So you've got your 3 Treeborns, summon them, and then tribute them for the Monarchs, so on and so forth. Combine them with enemy controller, take control of monsters, summon Treeborn again, then summon a Monarch from that. The reason I've got Delg as opposed to the Frost Monarch is because Delg is a spellcaster, as you can see. So if I can get him out, then he'll be one spellcaster for Machi Machi or Naruto. Then we have our Light Ray slash Soul of Purity and Light monsters. So these are used to special summon. Of course, you can tribute with Treebon Frog for Light Ray Mador. I like to set it because people decide to run into it anyway, thinking you've just got a nice effect monster down, but really you got a 3000 defense monster. They run straight into it, boom, they take quite a bit of damage, and even if they can get over this, they need two monsters with over 3000 attack to get over it, because once per turn this card cannot be destroyed in battle, so it's a pretty good card in that aspect. Light Ray Sorcerer is pretty good. Another one that you can special summon if you have 3 or more of your light monsters banish. There's lots of different ways to banish monsters. So you have Cyber Valley's effect. So when it's targeted for attack, you can banish it. The other one that I like to use a lot is to target one face-up monster you control and this card, banish both, and draw 2 cards. That gets rid of this and whatever else I happen to have on the field. Sorry, if I need, for example, if I need 2 more light monsters for Sorcerer, then I can banish this and Mador. Go into Sorcerer. Most of the time I use Valley and Treebon Frog, draw 2 cards, and a lot of the time they're 2 good cards. Eren Lightsworn Monk is there because her effect is, it was a toss up between this one and I believe her name is Layla the Spellcaster, something like that. But basically the reason I went this one is because she can send 3 cards from the deck to the graveyard, and if you attack into a defense position monster, you can shuffle that monster into the deck and not have to worry about it. So she's got a pretty good effect when it comes to battling. Plus, when you're sending those cards to the graveyard, those are just cards that you can Well, there's lots of different things you can do. Monster Reborn them. Use them as materials to summon Soul of Purity and Light. Use Soul Release on them to banish them to use Sorcerer. So on and so forth. There's lots and lots of different ways you can go about doing it. As far as this spell lineup, pretty basic. Dark Hole, Monster Reborn, Heavy Stone, Foolish Burial, blah, 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 blah. One for one because there are lots of level 1 monsters in this deck. Monster Gate and Reasoning. These are actually very underused cards, and I don't know why. I think more people should start using them, especially Reasoning. There are lots of decks nowadays that really require having cards in the graveyard, like for example, just a Chaos deck. Any Chaos deck in general requires you having Dark and Lights in the graveyard. Reasoning can get a lot of Dark and Lights in the graveyard and then summon another monster on top of that. So yeah, Reasoning is a very good card. I really like it. And a lot of the time people aren't targeting level 6 monsters. The most common I found is either level 3 or level 4. And I think in all my years since like starting Yu-Gi-Oh! Using this card Reasoning, I think someone may have called a correct level and I failed to special summon a monster. I don't know, maybe twice. I can't remember the last time it happened. That's how uncommon it is. Most of the time they're targeting level 3 monsters because a lot of decks run rank 3XYZ, so I wouldn't run it in that kind of deck. But in this kind of deck with lots of level 6s, level 1s, and then some level 4s thrown in, Reasoning is a very good card. And then last but not least, Soul Release. Now, Soul Release is absolutely fantastic for this deck, and fantastic in a lot of decks, actually. Any deck that you that your Banish Zone is like a priority, you need cards in that Banish Zone to use certain effects, blah, 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 blah. I would definitely recommend running some Soul Releases, because not only can you use this card to banish cards from your own graveyard, but you can use them to banish cards from your opponent's graveyard. So Dark Worlds is one deck that I ran into where Soul Release was really good. They were just they were sending these cards to the graveyard, especially Graffa, and then I was just using Soul Release to throw that into the banish zone, and then they were screwed. They couldn't use Graffa from that point on. So yeah, Soul Release is a very good card because not only can it benefit you, it can really hinder your opponent in a lot of situations. And I think that is it for the overall deck. As far as the extra deck, just very simple rank 6 monsters. As I said, there are very, very powerful ones. Inzektor Exabeetle is a very powerful one. You can just destroy monsters on your opponent's side of the field while gaining some attack points on the initial summon. Gauntlet Launcher is a very good one because it's one of those effects that you can use more than once per turn. So you can summon this. If your opponent has two monsters, then you can clear the field there and then, and then it has a nice 2,400 attack. If you don't want to use that, place it in defense, it has a nice 2,800 defense. So yeah, Gauntlet Launcher is a very good card in that aspect. Of course, Machi Machi and Naruto, I've already gone over those. Number 72, Line Monster. This is actually a really interesting card because you detach both materials, and then you can destroy one set spell and trap, and one face-up monster your opponent controls and destroy them both. And then all battle damage for the rest of the turn is half. So, yeah, again, a card that I really like and really interesting effect to clear the field. A really good combo if you can pull it off. Get a Photon Strike Banish on the field along with a Naruto. Their spell and traps are hindered, and their effect monsters are hindered. So, yeah, very good combination there if you can get both of them out. And that's going to do it for the deck profile, guys. So yeah, this is my rank 6 XYZ deck. Really consistent, really fun, really enjoyable, something different. So if you want to try it out, I highly recommend it. The deck recipe is there, so you can just screen cap it. Just have the video playing on the side while you make the deck. Whatever you want to do, that is the deck. I hope you enjoy it. I hope you have fun with the deck. If you enjoyed the video, remember to give it a like, Gray, and comment down below. Let me know what you think of the deck. And if you haven't done so already, hit that subscribe button for more videos. Again, guys, it's Ron Palawan, and I'm out. Peace. Thank you for watching.